You know, it's quite deceptive how nice and calm this music is right now compared to when you start the game.
Yeah, they like to blow out your eardrums and then just make you think you're deaf now.
Yeah, oh my goodness. Hey everybody, hello and welcome to SWTOR with Larry and MJ. Our bi-weekly or bi-monthly, however you want to say it, because it works both ways. Star Wars, the Old Republic streaming extravaganza. No choose my alignment tonight because we are just droid hunting. And there's nothing choice worthy in these droids, so it's just droiding. But we get to go Republic this week. Yay! Larry loves Republic so much, everyone.
Yep. So much.
So
Funny thing. Funny thing. Okay, you say you mentioned that though. I actually for a while, not this guild, but one of the other guilds that I helped run, was a Republic guild on the Imperial side.
wait, so you were all Imperial characters, but you played Republic, or you were Republic?
So as far as game mechanics were concerned, we were Imperial characters. But we were like undercover Imperial characters. We were actually all Republic characters, the characters themselves. In fact, my character, and actually all of our characters for that matter, had outfits that had Republic logos on them or looked like Republic outfits. But obviously, we wouldn't wear them in like the fleet or anything like that. But when we were out on missions, that's what we'd do. We'd wear those out. Yeah.
So you did have some love for the Republic there.
Only when I was a traitor. See, that's how that works.
Okay, so I am in on my.
Oh, are you on the Republic side now? Oh, is that where we're starting? I didn't know we were starting there. Oh,
Yeah.
I'm
Oh,
sorry.
well, isn't that what?
I don't
Don't we
know.
have just a bunch of Republic ones to gather?
We do, but we have, I thought we had some on the Imperial side too. Pull Andrea in here.
Well, we can do that later. Let's get all the Republic out of the way. And Andri has some news for us that flashpoint might have been fixed.
I doubt it. I'm sorry.
Well, there was a patch yesterday, and they added a little cutscene to the end of the storyline. I think it sets up further stories. And I tried to do the flashpoint, and the companion was level 25 as he was originally supposed to be, and the SWTORista was also doing a run with a new character, and she was even able to invite people to her group, and they joined her instance. So
No.
it's possible that it's fixed.
So we
That
might be trying that in a couple weeks
sounds
again.
sus.
Except in a couple weeks it might break again. Oh, that's what I'm thinking. But yep, I am on my pretty little Jedi.
Okay, I gotta figure out who I'm logging in because I have like, oh, I have a level 75 guardian? What?
Like not even know that you've played? Or was this like a bump up, huh?
I
Yeah,
don't
Akari, they
know.
fixed after they broke what they fixed what was broken. Yeah, Toaster, he probably the minute he's done playing, he like wipes it from his memory so he doesn't have to think about
That's right. I visit the MIB headquarters, and they just erase that completely from my memory.
So he doesn't have to
Right,
Feel tainted by Republic. You're
exactly.
such a wimp.
I'm trying to decide who I need to bring or who I can bring. Or
well, I'm only whatever. Level 52, but I don't know that that matters.
I think I'm going to bring the Guardian. I literally don't even know this character. I don't know this character. Like, I don't remember doing anything with this character. And it's not, like, below me or beneath me to have, you know, bumped up the character just because I didn't want to play through the class story again. And to be fair, and just so everybody's, you know, understands, I have played through all of the stories. I'm not just, you know.
No.
Yeah, so anyway, I'll log into this.
He suffered through even the ones he didn't want to do.
That's right. I suffered through the consular story.
Hey, I think that's actually who this is.
Yeah, probably.
She was one of my first characters.
I knew Akari would say something.
Why did Akari said, Shroud's Gambit just...
Because you need to have the quest in order to use the micro binoculars.
Oh, that's right. Do I have the micro? Okay. I don't know your character's names, but mine is really easy to spell.
Okay.
It's T-Z-E-E-L. Thanks. Oh, I think all of my buttons are in the wrong spot. Let me make sure. I'm going to kill somebody here.
I have only minimum beginner reset page down here on this character now, so it'll be fun. I don't know what all I can do on her. Who knows? I've got a few heals. Who cares, right? Cut to the technical difficulty stream. No, actually, let's go to...
With elevator music and everything?
We need to go to Coruscant first.
Wait a minute. Interface?
Okay. All right, Coruscant is where we're going? All right, I'll meet you there. Yep.
Huh.
Yep.
Do I have to start? How much of this quest do I have to start to get those binoculars, I guess? Is that what I'm going to do?
We just have to do the first bit.
The intro to it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we're just getting the droids. We're not doing
any Shroudy stuff right now, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Buttons are all in the wrong spot. Where are you going?
I guess I can go using the map.
Yeah.
I was gonna go get on my ship, okay?
Get on my ship! That's the long way.
Star Wars! Stars! Out in the stars!
Why? I mean, why do you... why?
Oh. My eyes aren't hurting as bad right now, guys. Aren't you glad for me?
I'm ecstatic. This guy's name is Morum. I don't know what I think about that. yeah, that's it. You click on the other. I did the same thing. I'm like, where's the open spot? I can't find the open spot.
Alright.
I don't think this character is... No, this is definitely a boost. I've definitely boosted this character.
No wonder I don't know a single thing about this character.
Yeah, I don't. That's weird. This must have been a late edition or a very early edition. No, it's a level 75. It had to have been a very late edition that I don't remember at all.
Well, this character leveled up on her own all the way here. No level boostings, cheatings.
Level boosting is not cheating.
Of course it is.
Unless you did it through some exploit.
All right. Just because it's game sanctioned cheating does not mean it's not cheating. Where are you guys?
I think we need to go upstairs, if I'm not mistaken, yeah. Right?
You do.
Well, I'm just checking. Are the stairs to the side here?
No, they're in the back.
No, at the end.
The very back. Your other back.
No, at the end of the big hole.
At the very end of it, okay. I just remember jumping down from up there. That's all I remember. Toaster says the light side Sith warrior, LS is light side, right? Sith warrior is my favorite original storyline. Wait.
Which, what is
no,
that?
No, LS can't be light side, can it? LS Sith Warrior is still my favorite of the original storylines.
Yeah, it's light side. Yep.
Wait, is Sith Warrior can be light side?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, they are...
Oh, that, just that's... making the light side choices and stuff.
Right. Okay. And actually, I mean, given, you know, the post Knights of the Fallen Empire, post that, they can actually be Republic, although they don't do Republic quests anymore. They just... Yeah, mechanically they're still Imperial, but as far as the story's concerned, they're Republic.
That's all really cool.
But the light side Sith warrior. There's a couple of different versions of the light side Sith warrior. I consider like the medium Sith warrior to be light side
light
as well.
Dark.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
You're talking
there's
about
like.
Steak.
There's like, medium, light, and dark. We're talking about coffee flavors. the fully light side one is actually very, it's amazing. And the other light side one, the other one that I consider to be light side is if you're still Sith and you convince Jaysa to be Sith as well, but you're mostly making light side choices. That is the one I would consider also light side, but you get a different story outcome.
All right, so what are we doing? Talking in here?
Yeah, we gotta do this storyline. Can I join this conversation? I can join this conversation. Okay, cool.
We're conversing.
Thanks for coming here to meet me. I'm afraid I'm not quite as mobile as I used to be. Shrapnel will do that. We've... been losing agents lately. A lot of talented agents. I have nowhere else to turn. So I hope you can
help. Talent agents?
A galactic legend's been brought out of retirement. A freelance master spy known only as...
The Shroud. Okay, this is not my flirty character, so y'all don't get to vote flirt on him.
But you're going to anyway, aren't you?
No, I'm not!
Oh, man. You're so disappointing.
She doesn't flirt!
Interested in the spy stand.
Oh, I didn't even get to vote. I didn't even, yeah.
Very kind, but I'm afraid this problem is far more important right now. The Shroud came back into SIS chatter after the Hutt cartel contracted him to gather intel on Republic and Imperial interests. In his spying, the Shroud found something beyond what the Hutts were looking for. A challenge he could undertake. A weakness he could exploit. On Coruscant.
You make it sound like this isn't personal to him. Almost like it's a game.
Word is, the Shroud doesn't act out of morality at all, but out of achievement. the more audacious the better. We don't know the exact nature of his attack on Coruscant, except that one of his top lieutenants reportedly resigned over its severity, fled to the Empire. I'm good at what I do. Really good. But all this is so overwhelming. I need your help to stop the Shroud.
You're the spy, not me. Oh, it looks like
Larry's choice, pick.
Andrew, pick.
I understand this has been a trial, but you have to keep going.
I have no intention of quitting. I'll be with you every step, figuratively, at least. One of our departed agents managed to intercept a shipment of the Shrouds. In it were several pairs of souped-up macro binoculars. I've got budget envy, data and environmental analysis, communications, even a special Mira Luka interface. Shroud spent a fortune on these things, which, ironically, you'll be using against him.
The Force is my guide. I have no need for trinkets.
I mean no disrespect, but unless the Force can recognize discrete data packets and send them to me, you will need this trinket.
You can.
Shroud's data is scattered among his lieutenants. You've got
ha!
A lead on
she
one.
Gave it to me because you didn't want it. Neener.
That will help us triangulate his precise location. I'll remain in constant contact, monitoring your incoming data to keep up with your progress. Working together, I know we can stop the Shroud. Good luck.
She's limping around like me, actually.
Cool. We have binoculars now.
We have binocs. Knock knocks. Oh, wow. Hold on, okay. I need to make it so that it's showing on my... quest list here.
Oh, yeah.
Too many things are showing. What the heck? What the hey? Everything is showing under the world here. What?
Hey, Bill Slowski. Thanks for joining us.
There we go. What the heck? There we go. Wow. Hey, Bill! Good to see you! It's not an MJ stream if the quest log isn't as cluttered as the inventory. Silly. Uh-oh. Wow. I almost didn't survive that jump.
Black Sun.
What?
Black Sun territory.
Oh.
Have the quick travel.
You confused me there for a second. What are you talking about? What?
You probably don't have the quick travel if that's a boosted character.
I do not. I have no quick travels.
So go take the cab. Go take the taxi.
That's what I'm going to do.
Oh, taxi boy! I'll just wait.
Are you in the Black Sun area already?
Uh-huh.
What?
Encrypted signal detected.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You said you leveled up this character.
Yeah. This is when I originally played this game. Before I did choose my alignment. Yeah.
There it is. I don't know what happened to my original Jedi.
Jedi?
I might have renamed it, and so therefore I didn't see it.
Oh, wow. Friends of friend, Tor preferred friend, 2,122 days ago.
All right.
Wow. That's, I got some mail going here. Found her 2,881 days ago. The first time I... And then first anniversary fireworks. Was that like the max days it can... Wow, I've got a lot of community... Oh, let me...
Oh, it's a curry.
Weed.
Behind you.
No, who's the lead? Invite.
Oh, it's me. Oh, wow, that's different.
Apparently, I made this character 805 days ago.
Oh, now you know when.
Which is 2.5 years ago, apparently.
Sorry, I just pulled out a couple of... Wow, I'm going to have to come back to her mailbox and get all those mounts and...
Okay. Following
Lost
Andrew.
A Jedi Master. Lost a Jedi Master Larry has. How embarrassing. How embarrassing.
This is rare.
Yeah.
Four Republic Jedis, not a single Sentinel.
And we're looking for a droid in here somewhere?
Yeah.
The droid is right up top.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to spot.
Oh. Hey, Kari, I do have a shiny new Sentinel on the other server. Well, it's not so shiny.
Next one.
Yeah, what's the next one?
My, the first one I leveled up is a Sentinel. Like I said, I don't know what the character's name is now. So I might have just missed it. Or either I didn't, or maybe it's not up to level now. Maybe it's still at like level 50.
My first character was Scoundrel?
Where's the second one? It's supposed to be around here somewhere.
The smuggler is the only story that I really, really like. Oh, well. Oh, okay.
Wow.
Did you fall down the middle?
I'm sorry. Wow. That was different. I was gonna, you know, slide along the edge, you know, like boarding.
You're gonna grind the rail.
I was gonna grind the rail, and instead, just and Ikari followed me to her doom. I'm so sorry, Ikari. Where are we going?
Back where we were.
That looks like a big drop. Can I make that jump?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can make it.
Oh, but I've left Kari again. Okay, don't jump in the middle! Apparently, that's not good.
Did you? Okay, you fed the death camp.
I did. The death counter has eaten. Toaster! Well, now we know for a fact Hikari would, in fact, jump off a bridge if her friend did.
Hikari, if all your friends were named Cliff, would you jump off of them?
Yep.
Oh, wait, that's you guys, not mobs.
Yes.
Okay, so in front of me, on top of one of those antennas, is the other...
On top of
those. Oh, wow, that's really tiny.
Oh, I
yeah,
see
it's
it.
Right on top of it.
Why does it say that?
Triangulate anything. Oh. But, you know, that is one of the Shroud's spy droids. Keep an eye out for more of those. They'll be worth tracking.
Okay, one more in this sector.
Somebody apparently clicked on one of the transmitters. You've got one out of four?
The first droid counts as a transmitter.
Oh, okay. Like, I don't remember. I was purposely ignoring a transmitter.
It was the same thing on Drummond Cuss. It's their way of letting us know that there's more than one thing that we can scan.
Wow, you were hopping through the floor. That was weird.
You guys up here?
Yeah, yeah. Go up.
This way?
Yes. Yeah, just keep going in. Keep going in.
Don't worry about the things that they shoot you. Just keep going.
I'm just trying to look where I'm going a little better so I don't lead Hikari to her doom anymore. Doom!
No, no. No, no, no. Lead Hikari to her doom. It's more fun that way.
Should be leading you to your doom.
I mean, you can try. I mean, it wouldn't be too difficult.
You lead me to my doom.
It's in here?
Yeah. I think it's behind us, but I think we can spot it from here. Yeah, it's up there. Right above us.
Directly above us?
Yeah, on one of those bridges.
Okay. I literally don't see it. Oh gosh, I was looking up higher.
Oh, it's right there.
Okay, so now, Justicar.
What?
Justicar territory.
Okay. I mean, the way you said that was like, just a minute, you know? Justicar. I'm like, what?
Now we wait for Boosted Boy.
Yep.
Oh, Boosted Boy. This is where that Call of the Veteran from EQ2 would come in handy.
I mean, you can summon me, but then there's like what? A 10-minute wait or something along that line?
Well, that's just it. If everybody had, like, the Call of the Veteran orb, then you can jump to someone, and then everybody can bring you to them once, and we'd make it through a bunch of them.
Or a warlock could summon. But that's a different game.
No, it's not. It's the same game with different skin.
Yep. Lasers instead of blunderbusses.
Yeah.
Me, Kari.
Oh, what's she holding?
Look. Look, this Correct. Person's name is Cell Phone.
Facebook doesn't work.
Ready? Hey, I discovered a new checkpoint.
Go you.
So, how do you like clicking on droids? Is this, like, pure entertainment for everybody in the chat room? Sure it is.
Droid clicking, we're droid clicking. Hey, achievements, man. Achievements are important.
Yeah. Sure. On the Bartle test, I think that's where I score the least.
The most recent one took my achievement level down, but it's not because I don't, I mean, I like collections and achievements and everything, but it just reached a point where it's like, well, I just can't.
So, just so viewers and fans of the website are aware, the Bartle test, Richard Bartle, the guy who created the taxonomy, does not endorse any Bartle tests at all. Even the one that was on, what was it, Gamer DNA? The original one? He did not endorse that one. You gotta go around this way. But it's fun. It's all fun. I love taking the Bartle test. See where I am.
Yeah, mine definitely changed from how much time I have to game.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's why my achievement one went down, because at this point it's like, you know what? I just can't. I don't have the opportunity really to do that. So instead of stressing that I'm not doing it, I'm not caring as much.
So I got a question, and this is just I know where I stand on it. I'm just curious where other people would stand on it. If a game, let's say, I'll use Conan as an example, just because Conan allows you now to create new maps, like 100% new maps. Do those maps, like, are you less enthused by the new maps if you were to go to a, let's say, a player-made map or whatever, and there wasn't any points of interest or weren't any achievements or anything along that line? Does that make it less appealing to you? Or is there still that exploration kind of?
Oh, no. It's still big-time exploration. And having that neat little, you discovered this, yeah, that's... I'd be really
like
sad not to
that?
See any of that. But it wouldn't, like, make or break a thing for me, because as long as I could still go and investigate.
Well, there's
you know,
a platform.
It doesn't have to tell me that, ooh, you can explore if I can explore. So the exploring's the more fun, the having the... More like if it was something that said, like, you know, you found this rare spot or something would be more fun.
Platform above us.
There's new maps coming out now that are player made maps. They're just like they introduced them several months ago, being able to do that. But you know, it takes several months for players to build these because they're doing it doing them in their spare time and whatnot. Now those maps that people started making whenever Conan first introduced it are now coming out, and some of them are amazing, like better than the original by far.
Have you scanned it?
I'm all set.
I finished.
Okay, so now there's only one here, so now it's to the old galactic market.
Oh, so Hikari, who isn't in channel but is talking in chat, says GTA Online is a perfect example of a map we explored to death with no real reward for doing so. Yeah.
Oh yeah, definitely.
I'm sorry. Which mark? You said where?
The other sector, old galactic market sector.
Yeah, I don't have to have the flashy message. You've discovered something. But I'd rather there were things around, like just a completely empty world, no, but stick an old journal under a waterfall, or you know, things to discover would be cooler for me.
You have this one.
What?
You quick traveled.
Yeah, I know. It was weird. I had this one. I don't know how I had this one. That doesn't make any sense. But oh well, I have it. I gotta bring you to a private server that I have for Conan and show you one of these maps that is just mind-blowing. It's still under construction, though. The one that I really, really like is still under construction, so if you don't cheat at the very beginning, you die of heat stroke. It's kind of funny.
Wait, we've lost Takari back there.
Uh-oh. They really need to make a moddable Star Wars game. They really need to do that. They really need to... like something that because that was one of my most favorite things to do in SWG was to mod the game, and the best thing we have in this game for modding is Star Parser or something along that line, you know, something that parses for raids. Other than that, there's nothing.
Okay, so you see this big building that we came out of.
Oh, the building
corner, on the corner, on this corner, there's an antenna right on top of it. Very long antenna right on top of it. It's there.
Has everyone got it?
Got it.
Okay, so now last one is Jedi Temple.
Okay. Do I have a quick travel there? No, I don't.
Start hoofing it.
Oh, did I get an achievement for that?
For what?
Oh, and I discovered the entry to the old galactic market. Even though I already had it. Yay.
While we're waiting for Larry, I'll just
tell us a story.
A story, huh?
My gosh, how long does it take to get to the Jedi Temple?
It takes a long, long.
Are we there yet?
It's a long road.
Are we there yet? I need to go to the bathroom.
Yay, a patrol tauntaun.
Toaster Master, I've heard that story before. You don't have to tell it again.
Yeah. It's kind of like the story of Darth Plagueis the Wise.
Yeah.
Darth Larry the Boosted.
Okay, you're going to have to explain that one. Hikari says the speeders here basically operate like the freeways in Columbus, Ohio. I've driven through Columbus, Ohio, but I don't remember anything about it. So what does that mean? I'm here, by the way. We can go do whatever thing we need to do.
Oh. All right.
Let's go to the temple then.
Go to the temple. Oh, and we're gonna find droids. Gee, I really want this achievement. Finding the droids. Going to the Temple of Jedi. Actually, it's the long road. That theme I started was actually Star Trek, so that was...
Oops.
Wow, I was doing that on purpose. Or do you mean oops about the mobs?
The mobs.
Okay.
So, this one is very hard to find. It's right on top of the pillar over there in front of me.
Found it. That one was supposed to be hard.
They have a cross. Okay, this is the speeder. The freeways in Columbus, Ohio.
Shouldn't you have gotten an achievement for that? Because I think we've scanned all six.
Uh-oh. Legacy, right?
So it's
under location, under Coruscant.
Yeah. Location, Coruscant, exploration.
Yep. Got it. No, there isn't. Well, it just says droid reconnaissance Coruscant, but it doesn't. Like, there's no little thing over to the side. It just says complete.
Found all the datacrons? No. I'm missing a droid. But I scanned every single one of them.
You probably...
I bet you it was the very first one.
Y'all saw me scan every single one of them.
Did you scan the first one, Larry? Or did the...
I did.
Oh.
Maybe that's it. You have to scan it too, MJ.
Well, no, I did scan it, though.
No, because the first one is also a quest item.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It might have not counted as scanned for the achievement.
I'm betting you it was that very first one.
I thought I scanned every one of them. So where is it at?
It's Black Sun Sector.
So Akari said they have a cross that goes through the center of a circle that goes around the edge. But the only way to get to a lot of the places is to go all the way around. Oh, in all the way around and then back out, especially on a bus. Yeah, it takes you an hour plus to get somewhere 15 to 20 miles away. I absolutely know what that is. And you know what the thing is? There's been some videos about it. I wonder if Austin McConnell did a video on it or not. He did something similar, but the way the traffic is done in most major cities is not revolved around getting people around the city. It's revolves around getting people from the suburbs to the city. It's all about urban sprawl is the way that like the buses and whatnot and the highway systems are all designed. And so to get from, like, if you're in St. Louis, just outside of St. Louis, there's a place called Chesterfield. And in order for me to get to Chesterfield, which is southwest, I live in the Northwest. In order for me to get to the Southwest efficiently, I have to go not south, I need to go east and then west.
MJ, remember where it was you go down the ramp?
So say, no, I don't remember where it was.
Okay, you go down that ramp to your left.
Or you hop off the end.
Oh, hop off the end? This end?
No, the other... That way. Yeah, that way.
Yeah, this way. And...
No, it's not... It's the other way. There's a door.
Oh, it's in the door. The door.
Yeah.
I forgot we went there first.
Because I've tried to scan it, and I couldn't. So I've reset the quest, so I'm going to try to do the mission. And if you cannot scan it, you probably have to do the same. If it's that one, it might be another one that we didn't scan? I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's
bugs. It's the one in here.
Yeah, I don't know, because I'm sure I did all of them. Yeah, it was the one right there.
Yeah, try to scan that one.
No.
Man, I wish I told you which ones you've done.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to try something. Reset your...
No, I don't want to just random reset it.
No, if you reset it, I think you can... You'll go back to the same phase that I am, and you probably can holo call it. And do the...
I don't want to run and get... I mean...
But I'm here already, so... If you can do the holo thing and get it, you can probably scan it right away.
Okay.
remember that when we are in party and we start a conversation, you can join if you're in the same mission through a holo communicator.
Yeah, see, that, I mean, you can, resetting it's not going to hurt anything. You're not going to lose an achievement because of it, and we're not going to finish the quest on this side.
Yeah, exactly.
So you want me to abandon Shroud's Gambit?
Oh, no, reset.
Reset it.
Reset it.
Okay.
Okay, so now you probably can join. Can you join the conversation?
No.
Oh, crap. Yeah, you have to come here. Shit. Whoops.
All right.
Where am I going then now?
Back to the planet power. But wait, don't come yet.
I bet you it's because it's an instance.
No, it's not that. If it doesn't work, there's no point.
Well, yeah, because I don't have any binoculars to do anything else.
You can get the binoculars.
You
just
probably have them in your inventory.
But regardless of that,
in your mission inventory, you probably have them in your mission tab.
No. It's gone.
No, they'll be gone. So if you go you need to travel to Andri, and then I can just port you back here.
No, she can quick travel to the Senate Tower. There's a quick travel. I'm already here. I'm going to try and
it should be up the north.
Yeah, suddenly all my words are gone too. Do you know which one it is? The top or the one under?
The most north.
Yeah, that one. The one at the top. The northern one.
Wow, now suddenly all the words are gone, so.
Yeah, that might be just control you.
Recalculating route. Yeah. But no, I will go back and watch the stream, but I clicked on all of them. So I don't know.
Since this is a quest item, if Larry, because Larry scanned it first, it probably disappeared for you and for me. So we didn't get it.
But I was already scanning it.
If my scan bar finished
before
yours,
ours, it might have.
Yeah.
Wait.
Yeah, on the plus side, we have another chance to vote flirt.
I'm not vote flirting. I'm not flirting with her. Is this the right one?
Yeah, it's
yeah. Sorry, I wasn't looking at the stream to see which way you were going.
Okay, so conversation for myself.
Yep.
Thanks for coming here to meet me.
Because we're not invited anyway.
I'm not quite as mobile as I used to be. Shrapnel will do that. We've been losing agents lately. A lot of talented agents. I have nowhere else to turn.
Wait. I just clicked the button and instead of going forward...
Thanks for coming here to meet me. I'm afraid I'm not quite as mobile as I used to be. We've...
Oh, that's right.
I take it by the codename that this legend's specialty lies in remaining concealed.
I thought he was just a myth back when I was in the academy, but he's real, all right. The Shroud came back into SIS chatter after the Hutt cartel.
Oh yeah, that's right. They changed the emote window.
Public and imperial interests. In his spying, the Shroud found something beyond what the Hutts were looking.
You can have it up all the entire time.
First, the cartel invades Mekheb, and now they're targeting the Republic directly.
The cartel commissioned the Shroud in their lead up to Mekheb, but only to spy. They want no part in the Shroud's plan.
We don't know the exact nature of his...
Well, I haven't even claimed emotes on this character.
I'm no spy. I'd like your assistance in the field.
Me? In the field? Not since a sabotaged astromech exploded into my leg. One of our departed agents managed to intercept a shipment of the Shrouds. In it, I've got budget envy.
Like most schemers, his own dark endeavors will become his undoing.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Even stripped of everything, he's still a formidable threat. The Shroud's data is scattered among his lieutenants. We've got a lead on one, but you'll need to identify key relay points that will help us triangulate his pres- I'll remain in constant contact.
Okay, so... Got that again. Wait, am I just getting deeper in the tower? I'm just trying to leave.
You can quick travel.
Oh yeah, where do I need quick travel to?
Black
Sun. Okay.
Yeah. To us now.
I'm coming.
That won't help us triangulate anything.
Yep, she never talked to me on this one.
That is one of the Shroud's spy droids.
Yep, and you get the achievement now.
They'll be worth tracking.
Yep, so his must have finished first, I guess. Because it did it, and it just kept going up, and I'm just like, alright, there you go, all done.
Yeah.
Phew! At least it was that one.
Okay, so... We have now Thyton, Horn Mantell, Republic Terrace, and Republic Balmor.
To go to Thyton first? Thyton?
Sure, let's go to Thyton.
Thyton the Python.
Yeah, let's go to Thyton.
Huh.
Where's that at?
It's there next it Coruscant.
There we go. If I go in far enough, I can... Woo! Akari, yes! At least it wasn't bugged forever. Thank heavens.
Yeah, like some things.
Oh, that's nice. There's one around here.
What's that?
I've only seen this place from a certain memory we were just at. I've never been here otherwise. Here.
Yeah, if you've run through the story, you've been here. The consular story.
Right here. I don't remember this place ever.
Yeah, you started over here.
A long time ago in the galaxy.
Yeah, yeah, you started over here, though.
Okay, go to the first... To the first speeder point. What the hell is it called?
Gnarls.
Gnarls speeded outpost.
Be safe out there.
Okay.
Your friends are safe there.
No, don't remember that place at all.
I mean, if it was your first character, that's been, what, 10 years ago now?
Just a wee bit ago.
Okay, I think it's over there in those rocks.
In the rocks?
Yeah, above those rocks, there on the right side.
I'll take your word for it, because I don't see it.
Let me check the screenshot.
Is it in the rocks?
No, it's... I think it's above... It's not a... It's above those that... The area where we came from.
Yeah.
It's above it. There's an antenna, and it's right on top of the antenna.
I can see it, but I can't focus on it. I can see it glowing right there on top of the antenna, but I can't. The binoculars won't focus on it.
Got it.
Move a bit back because of the ray shield.
Yeah, I tried going forward, that didn't work. It's like a little piece of pink bubblegum stuck up there.
Okay, next one is inside the Jedi Temple on the shuttle, on the transit shuttle zone where we leave the planet.
Mechanized travel is for official business only.
Well, at least they're not having to do this whenever this first came out, because at that point we didn't have access to every speeder point. I would have had to hoof it.
Yeah, we had to physically get there.
Yeah.
Go unlock the speeder! Woohoo!
Look at all these filthy Jedi.
My Jedi bathes, so shush.
You know the stench of the other Jedi on you.
Oh, did you guys not go inside, or you did?
Oh, we did. We're inside. Or I'm inside.
Ah! Thanks a lot for throwing me on the ground!
I didn't. I pulled you and you fell.
You pulled me and slammed my face in the side of the wall.
Mission accomplished. It's in the starport?
I just barely got here.
Hey, it's over there.
You see it? Because I don't see
it. Yeah, behind those antennas. You see it spinning?
No. I see it now. Okay.
sure I get data confirmation each of these times.
Okay, last one is in the forge.
Oh man, that is a long way away.
Yeah.
Ikari, I changed my clothes just to come here, so I don't want to hear it. At least I don't smell like the bowels of Coruscant.
Yeah, that was annoying. You had to go through the works in order to get to the temple because there was no direct direct speeder.
So I got a philosophical opinion question for you. Is this game better now than it was when it launched?
I think it is. Although I do miss the... I think the leveling is too easy.
Is for official business
now.
Yeah. Yeah. Forward camp?
Yeah.
Okay.
Be safe out there.
What do you miss?
The leveling experience in the old game was more difficult than it is now.
Yeah, that's where this person's levels came from. Hard fought. Now, where are we going from here?
We are going
this
to the
way.
Forge remnants.
Yeah, I personally am not. I'm not sure where I stand. Is this game better than when it launched? I mean, there are better things in this game than when it launched. Like, there is more content, and there is, I think...
not having to hand-grab speeders.
Yeah, like some of the things, better, costuming and things along that line. A lot of the aesthetic stuff is better. In fact, I mean, even they did a little bit of an upgrade to some things in the game, and so as far as aesthetics are concerned, and so that is definitely better. But I don't know if I can objectively say that this game as it stands right now is better than when it launched, because I don't know. I feel that when it launched, If you just look at the mechanics and whatnot, I think that there was better balance between the different classes. I think the classes were more interesting to play originally. Now they've just like added more buttons. If you know what I mean, it's not like they've made the classes any more interesting or better to play. They just, instead of having to have, 25 items on your bar, you have to have 27, that kind of thing. So I'm exaggerating. It's not 27. It's close though. Write a hyperspace beacon about it. Wow, did he like fall really slowly for you guys too? Or was that just me?
Over there, right in front of us.
I wasn't paying attention.
And I think we're gonna get aggro.
All right, I got it all for Tython.
Yep, achievement completed. Yay!
Okay.
Yeah, we got time for another one.
Lord Mantell?
Lord Mantell. Lord Mantell. Yeah, Lord, let's do that.
Is also three. The other two planets are six each.
All right, yeah.
Lord Mantell.
Old Mantell, okay.
Old Mantell.
Old Mantell is on the opposite side.
Yep.
Of course, from where we are.
Toaster, I'm serious. Write down your thoughts. From full Bree will even pay you for it. Hikari thinks it's more the change of companions. Some advanced classes like Sniper and Sage got saddled with horrible companions for a long time in the original game. Oh, I think all I have are my original companions, too.
Well, it's not just that. I mean, originally, your companions had a singular specific job. Now, your companions can do whatever. Which, by the way, Charles Boyd at one point, I don't know that it ever made it into an article, but talking to Charles Boyd at one point, he said that he was glad to see some of the barks, like they're called barks, they're things that that the companions say while they're throwing a heel or shooting somebody or something along that line. They're just random lines thrown in. He said he was glad to see that some of those barks came back because originally the companions were supposed to do every single position. We're supposed to be tank, healer, and DPS.
But they got... Because I remember you get a companion. As a healer, you get another healer. It was like, well, you're not exactly very useful to me. Thank you very much. Or...
Yeah, so that was one of the original concepts was that they were supposed to have all classes. Wait, I'm confused.
On the other hand, M14X is the best droid. Nikari says, of course, the whole thing they used to do where you would have a cutscene and then stealth heal character would be standing right in front of the boss. Oh.
I do think that M14X is one of the best characters. The voice acting on that is phenomenal.
I don't know who that is.
Trooper.
Oh.
It's the big giant droid. I don't think I can pull it out of this character, but big giant droid. He has the best voice actor.
Can you see it, Larry?
Yeah, I see it.
See, I only have on her Zenith, Kaizen, Theron, Nadia, Lieutenant Ireso, and C2N2.
Okay, now let's go to the volcano camp.
I said the volcano camp?
Yeah. If you have the quick travel, use it.
I don't see a quick travel for that.
What is his name? The actor. If it's who I'm thinking is, there's one actor that had something happen to him. Gosh, I'd have to look it up now.
No, I think that was another.
Was it not him? I forget who it was that had gosh, what happened even? He probably won't be able to do voice actor.
I think it was Tanovic, the actor that does Tanovic.
Because he's the actor that does Yoda. Where are we going? Volcano?
Volcano camp, yeah.
Got it. Tom Kane, yes. Tom Kane does that was who it was. I believe. Oh my gosh, now I'm going to have to look it up.
Yep, I'm discovering places here.
Yeah, you've probably never been here at Ord Mantell.
Yeah, most Jedi don't come here because it's the starting planet for the other classes.
I mean, I had the first couple points.
Yeah, Tom Kane suffered a stroke.
The knights end up here with Kira for a mission. Okay.
I don't know if there's been an update, at least not public update, for how it was doing.
2012. It sounds like it was just a year ago.
You see that that satellite dish in front of
it? Oh, I see it.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not there. Hold on, let me get there. I was looking up Tom Kane. Oh, lava is bad. Don't go in lava.
Yeah, toaster, 2010, 11, 12, 21. It fits. That's right. I miswrote on the doctor's form today. New patient thing. I miswrote 2001. I put 01 instead of 21, right? And I'm like, oh my gosh. I can't believe I just did that. And the lady near me was like, oh, if only we could just go back then. And I'm like, I don't know that I want to go back to that year. And then I was reminded that there was a lot of horrific traumas and deaths and stuff in that year. No, 2001 is not the year that I would ever, ever want to relive. And then add chicken pox to it, me almost dying. Yeah, it was was a bad year. Let's not ever relive that one.
Yeah, I get it.
Oh, wait. Yeah.
Now we go in.
Is there one out here? What? Oh, I already got that one. Yeah.
Yeah, you got that one.
We're still here waiting. Sorry. I just thought that was really funny. And I'm like, I don't know that I want to go back and relive the last 20 years.
I don't know. 2001, I was a good age. I could go back to that age.
No. 2002, but I do not want to relive 2001.
Well, you already know what happens.
Yeah.
Lost my mom, lost a baby, and those were only two of about the six things I had to deal with. No, I do not want to go back to that year. The chickenpox was like the icing on the cake. They thought I was immune to chickenpox because I kept being, I've been exposed, but I'd never get to it. So they're just like, hey, you just can't get it. Unfortunately, at that point, I had already been to the hospital because I had almost died, and I had so little... my system couldn't take anything. And then my daughter brought chickenpox home from school. Or no, my son did that year.
Over there on top of the hangar.
Well, he kind of stands out up there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And of course, there was 9/11 in there, and banking crisis, and yeah, that's... 2001 we'll never go back to. It's just not. Let's all agree that that year we'll just...
Yeah, I'm good. Let's leave that one behind, as long as we can leave 2020 behind as well.
Why not? Every decade is a year that we can just skip.
Yeah, right? I'm good with that. I'm good with that. Because
there's only 9 years per decade, people. One of the years has got to go. All right, I got that one. Sorry.
Okay, so Republic Terrace and Republic Belmora.
Okay, which we don't have time to do.
Wait, did I get the achievement? Uh-oh. Did I get the achievement?
You should have. You did.
Did I? I was so busy looking at chat, I think I'd missed it.
I think I saw it pop up in the stream.
I'm just gonna go make sure. Location... Wait, where are we?
Location...
Old Man.
Old Man Telly.
Old Man Telly.
2010 was actually pretty good for me. I liked 2010. I could relive that one. That was a good year. That was the first year in Massively, actually.
Mine too.
Yep.
Yeah, this year will be 11th anniversary in June.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you were hired like a month after I was, so.
Yeah, a month after.
Month after Bree. Yeah, Bree and I were hired the same day.
Yeah. Craziness, man. Yeah, that was fun.
Gosh, yeah, 2010. Bunch of cons. That was incredible.
Oh, yeah. My first GDC. Oh, wow. SOE Lives, I'd totally go back to those, too. Those were a lot of fun.
I totally missed out on ever going to one of those, and I am...
They still are the best. They were the best. There was so much.
Well, at the time that I was going to go to SOE Live, it was like 2000. It was before 2010. So it was like 2008, 2009, somewhere around there. Huh?
Still fanfare?
Yeah, it was fanfare, and at that time, you like knew the devs, even players like knew the devs. You know what I mean? Like you could go and just like hang out with the devs. It was an event, but it was more just, you know, going to hang out with friends that happen to play the same game as you do. But they developed the game, which is, yeah.
There was still a lot of that. That's the thing. They still had a lot of that through the SOE Lives.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's what I mean. I mean, that was like the whole SOE's culture at that time was awesome. That was like, that was an amazing MMO culture I don't know that you really find that anymore. I've kind of found it amongst the players of certain games. I've seen that, but I haven't seen that connection with the developers. I'll admit though, most of the games that I've been focusing on have been like AAA games, and so so maybe some of the more indie games are a little have a better connection between the fans and the developers. But there seems to be, like, currently there seems to be a real bridge or disconnect between the developers of a game and the fans of the game.
Yeah. And they almost have to now, though. I mean, look at how rabid and vicious people have gotten, that you have to have that extra layer now, because if not, I mean, you're getting, you know, your devs, your employees can't produce anything because they're so busy being harassed.
Right. Right. Yeah. I mean, there is a toxicity amongst fans, especially that didn't, well, I don't want to say it didn't exist before, but it wasn't as loud as it is now.
Yeah, it does seem to be louder. And of course, more time, more missteps, and the more anyone in the industry does a misstep, the more the collective holds that as, you know, well, that's already been a problem. It shouldn't be a problem anymore, you know.
Yeah. I remember when Twitter first came out, and I got on Twitter, and I was able to, because you can't do this now, like, not really. I just, like, had a conversation on Twitter with some of the SOE devs. That doesn't happen anymore. Like, you don't talk to, you don't just have conversations anymore with anybody on Twitter or whatever, because and you know what the bridge, I just thought, maybe I'm wrong, because it just came to me, what the disconnect is not that the devs don't want to, or it's not even necessarily the toxicity of the players, although that does exist and I don't want to discount that, I think it's because marketing. Because a lot of the community managers and whatnot aren't really managing the community. They're more of an extension of the marketing department. And so now they have to be super careful about what they say. And especially on Twitter. And before, like during 2008, 2009 or whatever, you could just talk to the devs on Twitter and they would respond to you just with whatever. They wouldn't be any kind of marketing ploy.
You know, you say that. It just made me think of, you know how they talk about gamifying things, making things more like a game? Games have been made into more of a business.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
so it's no longer, hey, we're making these games, we're doing these games, this is fun. But you're getting, it's like more suits are getting inserted, more, like the levels of disconnect between devs and players are there for protection as well, because where it started, but it's as you more businessify, it doesn't sound as good as gamify, businessify things. you know, it's like any misstep, that's not on the bottom line, they can't, you know, it's like, oh, but this would be really fun, no, we got to do this instead, you know. So I really think that it's reached the point where some of the fun is leaving the making the games, and I think that actually you can feel that, and it reverberates around the entire system. Because now you've got people having to do things for the bottom line, which they'd rather do something else. And so, but they don't do the something else, and the players want this, and they get mad, you know. And now everybody's got to kind of like, you know, someone making a game in their garage feels like they're actually going to, like, do better. Maybe not financially, you know, but, like, do better for their goal than a great big corporate subdivided parsed out something. Anyway, that's just my weird thought.
I'm not 100% downing publishers, because I think publishers 100% have a role in a game's development. I do, however, think that the corporatization, that's probably the term that you were looking for there earlier, the corporatization of games has really, I mean, it's done the same things to movies and any most anything in the entertainment industry. And I think that I think you'll still find game developers that are making games for fun, that are doing it at, you know, and that are doing a phenomenal job. It's just that because they aren't the large corporate entity, you don't necessarily hear about them,
right?
Whereas initially, and I get it's a growth of the industry and whatnot. The more people that are in there, the more corporatized it has to get and whatnot. So I mean, I'm not. It is what it is, and I'm glad there are still games that you can that are indie games that you can, you know, get in touch with the devs and have a little bit more personal interaction with them, but. It's just unfortunately the way it is, and that's the way it is with like anything in entertainment, is that the bigger that it gets, the more corporatized it gets, and you might not hear about certain games because bigger games have more marketing.
I have the louder mouthpieces.
And
it's like some of the movies and stuff now aren't necessarily being made for the art of it, the storytelling, the idea. It's the, you know, how much at the box office, how much can you pull in, and oh, this one was a failure because it only made $600 million at the box office, you know. And you're just like, but what was it, John Carter, the John Carter series, I really wanted to see a second one. Oh no, but it wasn't, you know.
Yeah.
It wasn't phenomenal enough to be worthy of more. And I'm just like, shut up. You know?
I mean, I kind of get some of that, and other times I don't. I mean, I know that certain certain movies can be made on shoestring budgets and do just and just be a phenomenal movie on a shoestring budget. I don't think John Carter's one of those movies that could be made on a shoestring budget. And if I'm not mistaken, I could be mistaken because I didn't really research John Carter that much, but I believe that, you know, that didn't make up the cost.
They screwed up by, they did not market that at all. They swept it under, and it's like, why even make a movie and not market it, people? people didn't know about it. Anyway, that's we're like going off on total tangents here.
We are. We're totally off. This game, however, is still going after 10 years. Let's spin that back around. This one's still going. The developers are still – it did have a gigantic budget, and although I don't think it has nearly as much of a budget as it should have now, but it still has a decent budget. There's still developers working on it. Hey, and now that Anthem has been canned, I mean, I don't think it's any secret that I have never liked Anthem. I thought that that was just from like, I don't want to say from the very, it was interesting to me whenever they first started talking about it, but once they started marketing it, it was, I just knew it was going to be trash just the way they marketed it. But anyway, now that Anthem is dead in the water, maybe now the BioWare Austin team can start working a little bit more on this one. That'd be great.
That would be awesome. Yeah, Natalia, yeah, Anthem got canned and Tor instantly got a new Splash movie.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, see? Great. Let's get those Anthem guys to work on Tor a little bit more.
Let's go for it. And when they do that, that'll give us more content to run through on our, you know, choose my alignment. So we're all for that. But next time, it looks like might try to give the Flashpoint a go. And if I do we'll see, maybe we can get any droids.
Or should we get two more droids? We get two more planets of droids. So
I'm going to Terrace, and then there's Nar Shaddaa to finish.
Yeah. So we might get finished with all the droid and stuff before the Flashpoint. So I didn't realize how many droids there were on these other planets.
Well, Balmora has 6, and the Terrys also has 6.
So we'll probably get through the droids at least next week.
Yeah, we can do the
Hopefully we can like get through the right before the Flashpoint on Nar Shaddaa, because the Flashpoint is going to take us the entire time.
I don't think we can, because on Nar Shaddaa there are another 6 droids plus the
That's right, we got to go on the other side. We got to go to the Republic side too, huh?
No.
We cross over to the Republic.
Yeah, there are shared areas.
But don't we still have to wait? Are you talking about a different Flashpoint than the one that I just tried before?
Yes. He's talking about.
Still need to do that Flashpoint. Is the one I'm talking about.
Oh.
We still need to do that Flashpoint.
Sure. If you would rather do that, sure. Sounds good to me.
So we have droids, multiple Flashpoints.
We can do. Well, how long is that Flashpoint? Is that Flashpoint going to take the whole time? I don't think it will, really.
If we go with a full party, it probably will. It might be quicker.
Yeah, if we can get a full party, and then we could probably do it.
Unless we can do that in some droids, maybe. Hopefully next.
Yeah,
time.
That's what I'm thinking.
I don't think we can.
I've only run it once and by myself, so I don't remember.
I did it today. It's solo. It takes a bit. There are some lore items and other stuff. I don't know if MJ wants to do those or not. But just to get to the trash and do the bosses, it will take about maybe not an hour, but at least 45 minutes, I think.
Well, if I go in solo and skip all the trash like I was doing, maybe.
Well, but then I mean, if it takes
you, you can get past the dogs.
We'll figure it out. But I mean, at the very least, we're going to do that. We'll do that Flashpoint. Maybe some droids.
We'll give it a try. That'll be it for next time. Guys, you want to know when that's going to be, it's 2 weeks from now, 8 p.m. Or you can check out the Stream Team calendar because we actually put it up for you right there on MassiveTheOP.com, where you will find all of Larry's writing on Star Wars The Old Republic. Nothing really new yet. And I don't think that I have seen a sword and board yet. Keep hoping. The new one?
Huh?
Sword and board?
What's that?
Yeah, I'll bug him about it later. It's all right there, MassiveTheOP.com. A huge thank you to Hikari and Andrew for coming and helping us out here. And to all of you for all of your support all the time on OPTV. You keep us streaming, and that keeps us happy. So thank you so much. Have a great night, everybody. Take care of yourselves, and we look forward to seeing you next time. So until then, be well.
Bye.
It sounded like a sheep, Larry.
Bye.